After almost 2 months waiting time, I finally received my new faceplates for the PlayStation 5. So I would say, let's get rid of the white ones and let's install the black ones. Okay, but before we do this, let's have a closer look on the quality from these faceplates. And if you're new to my channel, this video is sponsored by myself, so do me a big favor, subscribe to my channel, please. I would much appreciate it, okay? So, what about the faceplates? So first of all, the nice PlayStation logo is missing, but this is actually not a big deal breaker, but just for your information. What I also found is I really can't complain about the quality. It's really a nice quality. I couldn't find any difference from the material so far, so I haven't removed this at all. I'm actually not quite sure how to do this. Maybe I have to ask Google. But so far, what I can see, or what you can see, hopefully, I mean, there's not much to see because it's really actually perfect. There's no issue with sharp edges. There's no issue with the color. I can't find anything to complain, to be very honest, because the coloring is just perfect, you know? Okay, what of course is also missing is on the original PlayStation faceplates, you have your Sony logo and you have all these nice little symbols inside. This is also missing, but again, not a big deal breaker. And I ordered this on eBay, and if I remember correctly, there was the choice between three colors, so black, green, red, and blue. And as you can see, I decided to go for green.
But it's black, boss.
Oh, really, Tony? Okay, green, blue, black, doesn't matter, as long as it is white. No, anyway, so let's remove this. And I had to look it up, actually, how to remove the faceplates, because I had really no idea. Let me just put this here. So what we have to do is, we're starting with the side where the PlayStation logo is, and all what we have to do is, actually, we have to lift this up on this side where the logo is, and also we have to pull it down, push it down at the same time. So lift it up, and this was really easy, actually. And there's a lot of dust here. But anyway, and the other side, we have to do it on the opposite side, okay? So we have to lift up this side and pull it down, or push it down as well. So let's try this. Oh, this is more, okay, this was a little bit more heavy, but anyway, that's how it is. And here's a hair, and here's a lot of dust, and here's, by the way, the extension slot where there is still no solution from Sony, which is a little bit, anyway, different topic. But that's how the PlayStation looks like without any faceplate. And again, there's a lot of dust, but that's for another video. Okay, so let's install the new faceplate. This should be like this here. And looks quite good here. So where's the other one? Here. No. Look, now this is better. Yeah, that's it. That's my new PlayStation 5 in black. And it really looks good. It really, really looks good. I like it much more, or much better than with the white faceplates, to be very honest. All what I have to do, of course, now is to install the stand again. And then I can play again. Wow, this looks really much better. I mean, it's personal opinion, of course. But I think black, it just fits better. It fits all to my other stuff, to be very honest. So the PlayStation 5 was the only white thing. There's really nothing white here. No, just the Xbox logo is white. That's it, the rest is completely black. So that's why I'm really happy with this. So that's already for this video. There's not much to say about faceplates from my PlayStation 5. So really nice design, I really like it. I will put the eBay link in my description, so feel free to have a look on it. And yeah, again, that's it for my video. I say thank you very much for watching me, and I see you next time. Bye.